वीडियो नंबर 12 क्लास 12 मैट्रिसेस।
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज माय वीडियो नंबर 12 एंड इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो वीडियो नंबर 10 आई एक्सप्लेन अबाउट एलिमेंट्री ऑपरेशन ऑफ मैट्रिक्स एंड इनवर्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ इन्वर्टिबल मैट्रिसेस एंड सपोज देयर इज अ मैट्रिक्स इक्वेशन एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए इनटू बी देन हाउ टू अप्लाई द रो ऑपरेशन। सो वंस अगेन आई वांट टू रिवाइज अ फ्यू थिंग्स। Suppose there is a matrix equation x is equal to a into b, left side only a single matrix but right side there are two matrix a into b. So if we want to apply row operations, then all the row operation it will be applied on left side, there is a single matrix on x, and simultaneously on right side also, but only first matrix of this product, that is a, not on b. For finding A inverse, here we will write like this, A is equal to I into A, because suppose A is equal to A as it is, and this A into I means identity matrix, there is no effect. So A is equal to A, it means A is equal to IA, both are equal. Suppose for example, A is equal to A, then in next step multiplied by I, so it will be A is equal to I into A. Now, by applying row operations, and by using row operation, we will convert this matrix A into identity matrix. It means 1, 0, 0, 1. And the same operation will be applied on this unit matrix or identity matrix. Then this identity matrix will convert into some other matrix, because it is 1, 0, 0, 1. But when we apply row operations, it will reduce into some other matrix. And suppose this is B. Now look here, A into B, which is equal to I. Since we know that A into A inverse, that is I. So here B, which is the inverse of A. So this is the A inverse. Now, same as if we want to apply column operation. So once again, suppose this is a matrix equation, X is equal to A into B. If you want to apply column operation, then this operation will be applied on left hand side, there is a single matrix, there is no problem. But in right side, there is a product of two matrix, and this operation will be applied on matrix B, it means second matrix, not on A. So for finding A inverse, we can write here, suppose A is equal to A, and next step A multiplied by I right side, because we want to apply column operation. So now, this column operation will be applied on matrix A and simultaneously on matrix I, means unit matrix or identity matrix. Now, this A we will convert into unit matrix or identity matrix, that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, by using column operation. And by using this column operation, this unit matrix I, which is 1, 0, 0, 1, it will be converted into some other matrix, suppose B. Now we are A into B, which is I. So since we know that A into A inverse, that is I. So here B is inverse of A. Let's see by one example. First question of exercise 3.4. By using elementary operations or transformation, find the inverse of the following matrix if exist. And question is, matrix A is equal to 1, minus 1, 2 and 3. Let's see the solution. Suppose matrix A, which is 1, minus 1, 2 and 3. Suppose we want to apply row operation. Then we may write like this, A is equal to I into A. If we want to apply row operation, then this row operation will be applied on matrix A on left side, but on matrix I on right side, not on A, first matrix of this product. So in place of A, write matrix A, which is 1, minus 1, 2 and 3, and I, which is identity matrix or unit matrix, that is 1, 0, 0 and 1, and this matrix A as it is, because we have to apply only these two, all the row operation on these two matrix, matrix A and on first matrix of this product. So let's see here, our target is this A, this matrix A we want to convert into I means 1, 0, 0 and 1. So 1 is here, there is no problem. but in place of 2 we want to write 0. So on second row, this second row subtract from first row but multiplied by 2. So if we apply operation on R2 minus 2 times R1, we want to apply on second row this operation on second row. So first write second row, from second row subtract first row but multiplied by 2. So let's see here, first row as it is there is no effect. Now on second row, first row multiplied by 2 and subtract from second row. So this is 2. First row multiplied by 2, it means it will be 2. So 2 minus 2, it means this is 0. Now this one minus 1 multiplied by 2, so it will be minus 2. Now 3 minus minus 2, so it will be minus minus plus, it means 5. Once again listen carefully. First row multiplied by 2 and subtract from second, R2 minus 2 times R1. So first row multiplied by 2, so 2 minus 2, because 1 multiplied by 2, it means 2. So 2 minus 2, that is 0. And minus 1 multiplied by 2, it means minus 2. And 3 minus minus 2, so minus minus plus. So 3 minus minus plus, it means plus 2, it will be 5. Now, same as on right side. 1 0 0 1, this is the matrix. So first row as it is 1 0. Now, second row, from second row subtract first row by multiplied by 2. So 0 and 1 multiplied by 2, it means 0 minus 2, that is only minus 2. If 0 multiplied by 2, then there will be no effect. So 1 minus 0, it means only 1. So this matrix I, it will be converted into some other matrix, because we want to reduce this matrix A into I. So our first target, we will get 1 0 here. Now second target, in this place we want to write 1 and in this place we want to 0, because 1 0 0 and 1. So let's see, suppose if second row divided by 5, then we will get here 1. So on R2 multiplied by only 1 upon 5, or R2 divided by 5. So first row as it is 1 minus 1 and minus 1. Now 0 divided by 5, it means 0, and 5 divided by 5, it means only 1. Similarly on right side, first row as it is 1 and 0. Now second row divided by 5, so minus 2 upon 5, and here 1 upon 5. Now let's see, once again focus here, 1 0 and this is 1, and in place of minus 1 we want to 0, because 1 0 0 1. So in this place, this is minus 1. If we add R1 and R2, so on R1, if we add this 2 row R1 plus R2, so we want to apply on operation R1. So first write R1 plus R2. So 0 plus 1, it means only 1. Plus 1 and this is minus 1 cancel out, you will get 0. Second row as it is, because we will apply on first row. Now adding this 2 row, 1 plus minus 2 upon 5. Let's see here, 1 plus minus 2 upon 5. 5 is LCM. So 5 minus 2, that is 3, 3 upon 5. So this is 3 upon 5. Now 0 plus 1 upon 5, that is 1 upon 5, no problem. And second row as it is, minus 2 upon 5 and 1 upon 5 into A. Let's see, this is identity matrix or unit matrix 1 0 0 1, it means this is I. And this matrix, this is B or A inverse, and this is matrix A. So A into A inverse, which is I, so here this is A inverse. So A inverse, which is 3 upon 5, 1 upon 5, minus 2 upon 5 and 1 upon 5. Let's see one more method. Here we applying only row operation. Suppose if we decided that we want to apply column operation, then let's see once again this question. 1, 2, minus 1 and 3, and we want to apply column operation. If you want to apply column operation, then we may write A is equal to A into I, unit matrix or identity matrix on second second or right hand side product of second matrix. A is equal to A into I, because on applying Coulomb operation, all the operation will be applied on first there is a one matrix on LHS, and in right side product of these two matrix, so this operation will be applied on second matrix, not on A, because row into column, first row after that column, so this is column operations, so it will be applied on second matrix. So in place of A, write 1 minus 1 2 and 3 matrix A, which is given A as it is, and I, it means 1 0 0 1, that is identity matrix. Now this A convert into I means unit matrix 1 0 0 1, first column and second column. So here in place of minus 1, we easily convert into 0, C2 plus C1. So on C2, add this column. So first column 1, 2 as it is. Now 1 plus minus 1, you will get 0, 2 plus 3, that is 5. Similarly on right side, matrix A as it is, on this identity matrix A, first column 1, 0 as it is, no problem. Now 1 add into 0, so 0 plus 1, which is 1. Now 0 plus 1, which is also 1. Now next step, 1, 0, 0 and 1. Suppose if you want to 1 here, then on C2, second column, which is multiplied by 1 upon 5, this column is divided by 5. So first column 1 and 2 as it is, this is 0 upon 5 means 0, 5 upon 5, that is 1. Similarly on right side, 1, 0, first row as it is, first column as it is, 1 upon 5, and that is also 1 upon 5. Now once again observe this matrix, 1, 0 and 0, 1, we want to make 0 here. So think on column, this is 2 and this is 1. So on C1, first column, if we apply C1 minus 2 times C2, first column as it is, and subtract second column but multiplied by 2. So first column 1 minus 2 times 0, it means only 1. 2 minus 2 times 1, 2 times 1 means 2. So 2 minus 2, that is 0. And second column as it is, because we were applying this operation only first column. Similarly here, matrix A as it is, on first column, on C1, minus 2 times C2. So first column 1 minus 2 times, 2 times means 2 upon 5. Let's see here, 1 minus 2 upon 5. 5 minus 2, that is 3 upon 5. So this is 3 upon 5. Second, 0 minus 2 upon 5, multiplied by 2. So 0 minus 2 upon 5, which is only minus 2 upon 5. 1 upon 5 and 1 upon 5 is. So this is identity matrix I. So it means this is A inverse, because A into A inverse, that is I. So here A inverse is 3 upon 5 minus 2 upon 5, 1 upon 5 and 1 upon 5. Answer is same. Either we want to using row operation or we want to apply column operation. But don't change. If you decide first, if you want to apply row operation, then through all this question, all this process, you have to apply all row operation. But if you think you want to apply column operation, then all this process, you have to apply column operation. Okay. So let's see one more question. Example number 25. Find A inverse if it exists, given that matrix A is equal to 10, minus 2, minus 5 and 1. So let's see the solution. Matrix A is equal to 10, minus 2, minus 5 and 1. Suppose if we decided that we want to apply row operation, then we may write A is equal to IA, because in row operation we have to apply all the row operation on first matrix of this product on right hand side. So let's see here matrix A, which is 10, minus 2, minus 5 and 1. So we want to convert this matrix into I, it means 1, 0, 0 and 1. So here we want to apply row operations. So this is 10 and this is 5. So if 5 multiplied by 2, and this is minus 10, then minus 10 will be added in first row. So first we are doing on first row R1 plus 2 times R2. First row R1 plus 2 times R2. So this is first row. We have to apply on first row. So second row multiplied by 2. So 5 into 2 minus 10 minus 10 plus 10, it will be 0. Once again, second row multiplied by 2. So this is plus 2 and this is minus 2. So plus 2 and minus 2, once again 0. And second row minus 5 and 1 as it is, same as on right side. Now first row, it means 1. So 0 multiplied by 2, it means 0. When we add in first row, there will be no effect. And 1 multiplied by 2, it means 2, and 2 adding here, so 0 plus 2, it means 0. And second row 0 and 1 as it is. Now let's see here. Since here all the elements of first row in left hand side, all the elements of first row in LHS matrix are 0, therefore matrix A does not exist A inverse. So if all the elements of any row are zeros, then matrix A does not exist its inverse. Let's see this question once again, and now in this time we want to apply suppose column operation. So when we apply column operation, we may write A is equal to A into I. Here we want to use column operation, so all the column operation will be applying on second matrix of product of A into I. So first matrix A as it is 10 minus 2 minus 5 and 0 into A, and this is I 1 0 0 1. Column matrix, suppose this is first column and second column. So first column which is 10 and second column which is 2. Suppose 2 multiplied by 5, it means minus 10, and add in first column. So first we here using on C1, first column C1 plus 5 times C2, this is C1, and C2 multiplied by 5 and add in first column. So 10, and this is 5 into minus 2, it means minus 10, minus 10 will be added in first column, then 10 and minus 10 cancel out, only 0. Second, 1 into 5, it means 5, when 5 add in minus 5, you will get once again 0. And same is here on right side also. 0 into 5, it means 0, so 1 as it is, this is 1. Now 1 into 5, it means 5, and 5 will add here, so it will be 5. Now all the elements of first column which is zeros, so in this case there is no inverse. So let's see exercise 3.4, which is homework for you. Using elementary transformation, find the inverse if they exist. Question number second, first already done. So second, 2, 1, 1, 1, and answer is this, 1, minus 1, minus 1 and 2. Third question, 1, 3, 2, 7, answer is here. Fourth question, 2, 3, 5, 7, answer is here. Fifth also, 2, 1, 7, 5, 7, 4, answer also here. Question number 6, 2, 5, 1, 3, answer is here. Seventh question, 3, 1, 5, 2, this is the answer, inverse. Eighth question, 4, 5, 3, 4, this is the answer, inverse. 3, 10, 2, 7, and that is the answer. 3, minus 1, minus 4 and 2, and this is the answer. Number 11, 2, minus 6, 1 and minus 2, and this is the answer. Question number 12, 6, minus 3, minus 2 and 1, and in this matrix, when you want to apply row operation or column operation, you will get, you doesn't get its inverse. So inverse does not exist in this case. Question number 12. 13, 2, minus 3, minus 1 and 2, answer is this. And once again 14, 2, 1, 4, 2, in this case also inverse does not exist. So try this question. I think it is a sufficient homework for you. So first you decide you want to apply row operation or column operation. So if you want to apply row operation, then all the process of calculation you have to use only row operation. And if you want to apply column operation, then in the whole process you will apply all column operation on both sides. So okay, thank you guys.